My name is Ryan Robles. I'm 35 years old. I was born in Pittsburgh, California, near Antioch, California, Contra Costa County, East Bay County, California. Near the Bay Area. It's close to Silicon Valley. It's probably about an hour out or something like that. I just got tipped by Google that apparently they're rejecting my testimony regarding the Shenyang incident. So there's a little censorship going on. I don't know if this video is going to make it out to the web or not, but I am assuming that it is, and so what I wanted to do was talk a little bit about my 9/11 confession, and sort of, I guess, tease everyone about what's going in my book. Basically, the first episode is going to be an autobiography, and it's going to talk about the Free Zone and my childhood, and kind of the way things went growing up, and of course leading up to the basically 9/11, the granddaddy of them all. So basically what happens is I get a leak, I get a tip from a deputy attorney prosecutor. I have no idea who he was. I went looking for this guy in the months leading up to 9/11, letting him know that I was ill-equipped and no one believed me. No one really thought it was that serious that the attacks were going to happen. So, I didn't want to look like an idiot. I didn't want to get fired. So I didn't use the corporate email. I kept it just to word of mouth in case the attacks didn't happen. And I was, you know, like it was a crank call or crank email or something like that. I was already having a difficult time just getting to work on time. So the last thing I wanted to do was some phony crank to the FBI and take time off work, and then I look like a phony. This guy doesn't know anything. And then pretty soon, I get fired for something. So, there were some people that were contacted, some people knew. I dodged a house party. They tried to evidently bust me with narcotics and get me hauled in for questioning and that type of thing. I didn't fall for that. The media did try and reel me into a porno shoot. This was in late 2000 with a homie, and he was a rich homie too. And but I didn't fall for it. You know, I didn't want to get critiqued or anything like that. It was I hadn't spent enough time at Reuters. You know, my job was very important, and I didn't want to be scrutinized the entire time I was at Reuters for anything. So I dodged the limousine or the porn stars at that time. They ended up catching up with me with my ex-girlfriend anyway. I think it was in September of 2002 when I got to finally experience like a bomb-ass porno chick, and they were able to convince my ex-girlfriend to play along, and I got my taste of it. I got like close to 6.5 hours of porn. I mean, it was pretty intense. I didn't have enough. I was totally maxed out, and I could have went for longer if I wanted. Oh yeah, but basically, what's going to go in my book is who I contacted, when, what I knew, when I found out, and what I tried to do about it. And there was a little, you know, detective work that went into discovering that I, in fact, knew something. And I desperately wanted to do something about it. I mean, I desperately wanted to, no one would believe me, though. That was the whole problem. And I think that my only option was the military at the time. And I had a really nice job, and I didn't have enough college credits anyway. So I figured, well, I was like 21, you know, that summer before the terror attacks, and I had just gotten a big gig at Reuters, and I was I did make a move on it with a coworker, but he didn't. He said he told me that by the time he got into work, it was already too late. That the buildings were already attacked, and because it was 6 o'clock in the morning, Eastern Standard Time, I said it was too late. But I warned the guy the night before. I mean, it was like, I was like, you got to do something. You've got to, you know, then do it now. I was like, you've got to warn, you've got to leave some voicemails, send some emails, do something. And he totally flipped out. He was like, damn it. And a whole bunch of other, he flipped, and, later on, you know, months and months and months and months later, he identified me as a whistleblower and told me that, quote unquote, you'll see. It was unbelievable. I was personally offended by the 9/11 terror attacks. I thought that was an insult. You know, considering the military capabilities at that time, and later on in 2004 and so on and so forth, I would discover that it was entirely political. So I'm going to hash out in my entire 9/11 testimony, and my relatives were even contacted, and they didn't want anything to do with it. Like, oh, what? Acted like I didn't know what I was talking about, or they've been on cloud nine for years. I mean, I'll be honest with you, they're a bunch of ex-Scientologists. They don't care about that type of stuff. So I found out my dad wasn't a counterterrorism expert, basically. Yeah, but all of that led to the Shenyang incident. And I was entirely debunked from joining the military from that point on. Basically, they didn't want anything to do with me. So...